church remains closed, but our hearts are wide open. Today we will be dealing with revival. Lord, revive us again. We will be talking about soul saving, the Holy Ghost, and what it's going to take to meet our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But first, we're going to have a solo coming from Brother Anthony Fox on the steel guitar.
If you watch that video, you don't need to be black to be outraged. You need to be American and outraged. Fear. We're the ones getting killed. We're the ones getting shot. We're the ones that were denied to live in certain communities. We've been hung, we've been shot, and all you do is keep hearing about fear. It's amazing why we keep loving this country, and this country does not love us back. And it's really so sad. Like, I should just be a coach. And it's so often reminded of my color. You know, it's just really sad. We gotta do better. My dad was a cop. I believe in good cops. We're not trying to defund the police and take all their money away. We're trying to get them to protect us, just like they protect everybody else. I didn't want to talk about it before the game because it's so hard, like, to just keep watching it. All we're asking is you live up to the Constitution. That's all we're asking everybody, for everyone.
The earth is shaking.
Yeah. Thank you.
Who gonna save the babies? Yeah. From another bloody Sunday, I'm singing Mayday, Mayday. Yeah. They love me or they hate me. Yeah. For my skin color. Yeah. But you say I am your brother.
The government keep lying to me, telling me that they come to set the people free. But the power falls when you catch us on the knees. Heaven please, we're in a state of emergency. See, we need a strong God, yeah. We need the real God, yeah. The God with the resurrection power from the grave. Take away the hate, to heal the human race, yeah. We need a, we need a, we need a, we need a strong God.
Sometimes you need to feel the pain and sting of defeat to activate the real passion and purpose that God predestined inside of you. God says in Jeremiah, I know the plans I have for you. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Purpose crosses disciplines. Purpose is an essential element of you. It is the reason you are on the planet at this particular time in history. Your very existence is wrapped up in the things you are here to fulfill. Whatever you choose for a career path, remember the struggles along the way are only meant to shape you for your purpose. Ready? Now, this is your time.
See, we need a, we need a, we need a, we need a strong God. See, we need a, we need a, we need a, let's go.
As the Spirit of the Lord continues to fill this house, go with me, if you will, to two passages of Scripture. You would notice Israel 9 and 8 and Psalms 85 and 6. And the Bible reads, and now for a little space, grace has been showed from the Lord our God to leave us a remnant to escape, and to give us a nail in his holy place, that our God may lighten our eyes and give us a little reviving in our bondage. As we move into Psalms 85 and 6, will thou not revive us again, that thy people may rejoice in thee? I want to leave this with you. We need a Holy Ghost revival. Revive us again. We need a Holy Ghost revival. Somebody need to come back to God. Somebody need to go back to Pentecost. Somebody need to go back to the cross. I'm going back to my church where I first got saved. If the house of God was good enough for me to get saved, the house of God ought to be good enough for me to stay saved. Revive us again. Touch me, Lord, one more time. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sins, and I will heal the land. Revive us again, Lord. Touch us again, Lord. Fill us again, Lord. We need a Holy Ghost revival. For we were bondmen. We were slaves, sold out to sin. Men and women bound to service without wages. For the Bible says that the wages of sin is death. Yet our God did not forsake us in our bondage. But God has extended mercy unto us, to give us a reviving, to set our house in order, and to repair the damage we have done to our soul. Revive us, Lord, revive us. Revive us again. Listen to what Jesus said. I know thy works, that thou hast a name, that thou livest and art dead. Hallelujah. Be watchful and strengthen the things which remain that are ready to die. For I have not found thy works perfect before the true and living God. Remember therefore how that thou hast received and heard, hold fast and repent. He that overcometh the same shall be clothed in white raiment, and I will not blot out his name out of the book of life. He that has ear, let him hear what the Spirit has to say to the church. Revive us again. We need a Holy Ghost revival, old-fashioned revival. Ask for the old path, which is a good way. Revive us that we might rejoice. Revive us that we might be happy. Revive us that we might be holy. Revive us that we, hallelujah, might rise up and live right in God's sight. Revive us that we might run and not be weary. Revive us that we might walk and not faint. Revive us. The Spirit of the Lord is moving right now. Revive our spirit. Give us a spirit of humility that we might have a heart, that we might be able to love everybody. Revive us again. We need that Holy Ghost revival. We have lost our fear for God. Not only that, we have lost our fear of God. The fool has said in his heart that there is no God. Revive us, oh God, again. Take us back to Pentecost. Take us back, oh God, to the old landmark. Put us on our knees again, hand clapping, foot stomping. All that we need, somebody turning their plates down, fasting unto the Lord, calling on the name of Jesus, until that old-fashioned Holy Ghost that keeps us and molds us and draws us closer to the Lord, revive us again. God bless you. A revival is renewing, refreshing, and restoring that which is already there. What I remember from my first revival, and I remember that one the most, the late Elder Eva Williams called me and gave me an opportunity as a young preacher to come and preach my first revival. And when I got there, the altar was full with little children, and Elder Eva had a big stick in her hand, and she said, "You're going to the altar tonight. You're not going to be worried about cartoons and Heckle and Jekyll, but somebody in here is going to get saved." And I thank God that many of the children that night received the Holy Ghost. Just like a revival, we're getting ready for the annual State Assembly. The State Assembly is symbolic of a revival. We are there day and night, and we are calling on the name of Jesus. You're invited to come and stretch out on the Lord, preaching, praying, singing, shouting. Everybody happy, nobody doubting. This year's State Assembly will be virtual. And of course, the reason why it will be virtual is because of the pandemic. And we are going to be stretching out each night, and it's going to give you a chance to stretch out in your home as you watch the annual South Carolina State Assembly. Lord God, our Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, in the precious name of Jesus, in the powerful name of Jesus, in the healing name of Jesus, in the saving name of Jesus, in the wonderful name of Jesus, Lord God, we thank you for Jesus. Oh God, we bow our heads this day. We pray that you would touch every home, touch every family, name by name and one by one. Oh God, even in the hospital. We pray now as we are in the midst of COVID-19. We pray for the doctors, the nurses, the hospital staff, the orderlies, the scientists. Oh God, work through them. They cannot do it without you, because we know that up above our head, divine healing comes from above. But we thank you for every medical staff person. We ask, oh God, that you continue to lead and guide them. Look on the President of the United States. Look on the Congress. Oh God, Let the Holy Ghost somehow overshadow the company. Oh God, that men and women that are leading this country would listen to God and do the right thing. Oh God, we pray now for every preacher. We pray, oh God, for every teacher. God, as the schools are trying to open, bless our children. Bless the teachers, the administrators, in the mighty name of Jesus. And oh God, as we close this prayer, God, we know that death is all around us. The numbers increase day by day. But we humbly ask you to hold back the death angel. Oh God, because Jesus said, I am come that you might have life and that you might have more abundantly. These are our prayers. And we ask it, oh God, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.